Hey, my name is Venita Decker. I'm product manager here at Bruker BioSpin, and today I'd like to invite you to a lab tour to show you the Fourier 80 in its natural environment. So just follow me. Maybe you know the situation. You have just finished your synthesis and you need to quickly check your intermediates or your products, and NMR would actually do the job for you. However, either you have no access to NMR spectrometer or you need to queue up, and then you most likely can forget about this quick answer. However, the good news is Fourier 80 benchtop system is doing the job for you. As one can nicely see, the system comes as one unit. However, it has two housings. The first housing holds the magnet, our 80 MHz permanent magnet, and the probe where your sample is inserted. And on the smaller housing, we have the electronics hidden. So those two housings are separated from each other, but still come in one unit. And that helps us to keep the magnet at a stable temperature, which is really important that you get accurate data and that you can get reproducible data. On the other hand, the electronics are easily accessible just in case there's any maintenance needed. So it's a perfect setup for you. As you can see, the Fourier 80 fits nicely on a standard lab bench. Of course, you can also put it in a fume hood if you like, or on the table. On the back of the system, you can find the main connections and the power switch for the system. And in addition, the back panel provides two Ethernet connectors. One is used for the communication to the NMR PC. The other one is currently not in use, but ready for future purposes. Very interesting for some of the NMR experts amongst us. There's also a trigger input, which allows to control experiments externally and most importantly in real time by a TTL signal. And eventually, there's a USB port, which allows service access to the system. But coming back to the practical part. If you want to measure an NMR sample, you just take standard 7-inch long tubes with an outer diameter of 5 millimeters, really the standard that you are used to from high-field NMR systems, and you fill about 600 microliters of your sample inside such an NMR tube. But then, before inserting it into the system, you need to adjust the sample height, and therefore, you use our sample holder and you use the sample gauge, which you can find on the right side of the spectrometer. You just take the sample, insert it from the top into the sample holder, pull it through. Be careful, but pull it through until nearly the end. That's important. Take your time with doing that. Then you take the sample gauge, you insert from the top, the holder. And you can see now our sample has hit the bottom here, and you can see there's a line over here, and that one indicates your filling height, and it sees it's perfect. So that's the minimum filling height that we will need to get the perfect spectra. What you can also see is that here there's still a gap, and this one we need to get rid of. That's why we are pushing from the top carefully down, and now our sample is perfectly adjusted and we can insert it into the spectrometer. So we're taking it out straight, and we are just inserting it from the top. And basically, that's all you need to do. Everything else actually happens on the computer. So with our Fourier 80, there comes a nice user interface, which is straightforward and is called GoScan, and it's really intuitive and meant for the not so much experienced NMR users. So you just need to enter your sample ID, you select the solvent that you have used for your sample, and then you can select an experiment or several experiments based on our Bruker Pulse Program experiment library. So you don't need to know anything about NMR parameters at all if you don't need to. You just run the experiments by the tap of a button. If you want to get more flexibility and if you want to change parameters, that's also fine, because the Fourier 80 can also be operated with our industry-leading software, TopSpin. So you can also operate it with TopSpin. You open it on the same computer and you can set up your experiments to your needs. You can run them from TopSpin, or you can even import the experiments into GoScan very easily, and you can again hide the experiments behind the buttons. So then not only you have access to NMR, but you also allow your not so experienced colleagues to use NMR. And that's it.